folks. Today we're going to do Troublemaker by Ollie Murs. We're going to be doing some bar chords here and some open chords. So it's going to be a nice little sort of beginner slash intermediate lesson, this one. So let's get started with it. Right, our first chords. Let's go through these. We're going to have four chords altogether, so we'll put them up on the screen. Got our capo here at the first fret as well, so that's an important thing to note. Our chords are G, F sharp 7, B minor, and we also have E minor 7 as well. So we're going to be starting with this G bar chord. Now, you'll probably know a G like this, which is just like a normal open G. We're going to be playing our G bar chord like this, okay? So use that chord diagram to help you. We're going to be barring down at the third finger, the third fret with our first finger here, and making our power chord sort of bar shape here, which is going to be third finger and pinky on the fifth fret of the fifth and fourth string, and the middle finger at the what would be the fourth fret from the capo on the third string. Okay, and then we're going to move back one fret, so let's shift back towards the capo here, lift off the pinky, that gives us F sharp 7. If we move the shape one below, so our root starts on the fifth string here, and put our pinky back down underneath our third finger, on that would be on the third string this time, at the fourth fret, that will give us B minor. E minor 7 is going to be the third and pinky finger down at the third fret on the first and second string, and our index and middle finger on the second fret of the fifth and fourth string. We'll strum all the strings there. Okay, so our rhythm for this part is going to be moving from the G, F sharp 7, and B minor. We're going to start like this. Okay, so the basic rhythm is we're using a lot of mutes here. So when we're muting the strings, what we're going to be doing is lifting off the pressure from the strings on the left hand to give us a dead sound like this. And then when we need the chord, we press down hard. So that'd be putting down the pressure, lifting off, and that gives us the muted sound. We start with two mutes. Okay, so two mutes. Two chord stabs on that G. So that's putting down the pressure, lifting off, putting down the pressure and lifting off. And then a down up on the mute, change to the F sharp 7. And that's going to be three hits there. And we're going to put ands in between. Okay, so. Okay, so that's going to be like a little bit of muting mixed with the chord stabs as well. Okay, now the B minor chord is going to be, okay, so that's four down strokes, then a little up, a couple of mutes, and then back down again. Okay, so I'll play through this really slow, see if you can follow through this part that we're doing here. Once more. We speed it up. Okay, that's our first part. We're also going to be doing the same once we've played that through. I believe it's three times through in the verse. We're going to change to this E minor 7. We're going to change to an E minor and then a G. And F sharp. Okay, so I'll show you how this change will go through. Okay, so you see we're changing, instead of going to a B minor, we're going to an E minor 7. Try and do that same pattern as well if we can. Okay, muting's a little bit trickier on this one, so we're going to have to use our right hand to help us here. Okay, you can be a little bit more strict on this one with the muting on the right hand here. Okay, so that's strumming down and then muting it out with the heel of your palm here as well. Alright, so our verse is going through G, F sharp 7, B minor. We'll do that three times, and then on that last time, we're changing to the E minor 7 with a G and an F sharp 7. That leads into our little pre-chorus part, which is our second part out of the three for our song. Okay, so let's move on to that pre-chorus now. Right, our pre-chorus. We get to use some nice octave shapes for this, so this is quite an easy section. If you know an octave shape, this should be fine. If not, I'll quickly show you. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be playing the 2nd fret on the 5th string, that's from the capo, 2nd fret here, and the 4th fret on the 3rd string. Now you can use either your 3rd or your pinky here to play those notes, it's really up to you. Okay, I prefer using my pinky, so I'm going to do it like this. Now we're going to do this, we're going to go, we're going to be shifting from this shape here, moving it along 3 frets, playing exactly the same shape again. And then moving it back. Now it's important to note that when you're playing this, you don't want any open strings, okay? Because that's going to really make the octave sound really, really off and not very good. So you're going to have to practice muting out strings with your index finger. For example, the string in between, our 4th string in between our 2 fretted notes, that has to get muted out with the 1st finger, as does the 1st and 2nd string as well. So it takes a little bit of practice if you're new to this, but we're going to be going. Change it from 2 to 5. And then we'll go up to a G, a bar chord, which you did before, and then an F sharp 7, and that will lead into the chorus. Okay, so we'll go through it again. We're going to go from 2, then again 2, 5, 2. Okay, so we're using the root to change 2, 5, 2, 2, 3, 2, 5, G chord, F sharp 7, and that'll lead into the chorus from there. Okay? So that's our little pre-chorus section. So let's move on to our chorus now, and we'll get through that. Right, our chorus section. What we're going to be doing for that is we're going to be playing very similar chords that we've played before, but we're also going to be adding in a couple of extra chords that we've not played yet. Okay, so we're going to be using a B minor, which we've done, an E minor 7, which we've also done, an F sharp 7, which we've done already, and an A and a D chord, which are new, but are very basic guitar chords, so you should be fine with these. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be playing them in a specific order. So keep an eye on the chords on the screen here so that you can work through these, okay? So B minor is our first chord for the chorus, followed by an E minor 7, followed by an F sharp 7, which is the bar at the 2nd fret there, back to B minor. Then we're going to go B minor again, E minor 7. Then we're going to go to an A major chord, then we're going to go to a D. Okay, so we're going to be playing through these, 1, 2, 3, 4, we can play through it 4 strums on everything just to get started with it. So 4 strums on a B minor, 4 strums on E minor 7, 4 strums on A, 4 strums on D, and that'll help you get through the changes, because these changes are a little bit trickier, changing from bar chords to opens. So take it slowly, maybe do 4 strums on each, and then what we'll do is we'll do the strumming pattern for this part, okay? So the strumming is. So that's. So we'll go from the B minor to the E minor, we'll do it really slow. Down, up, down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, up, down, down, up, down, down. It's always the same strumming pattern between two chords. So the chords get put into two little groups and you play the same strumming pattern with each group of two chords that you do. Like that. Seven, then the last time, A, then D. Do it again. Once more. Finish it a little bit differently. Okay, so at the very end of the chorus, you're strumming 2 A's, very staccato like, and then hold a D afterwards. So it's 2 A's, You can chop these out using the heel of the palm, and then a big D in the end, and that'll lead back into the. Which is our verse. Okay, so that's all there is to the tune. Thanks for watching, folks. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, feel free to rate, comment, and subscribe. If there is any requests that you would like, leave them in the comments below. And if there's ones that seem to pop up quite a lot, then I'll have a look at doing those for our next tutorials. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next.